So here's some information regarding atmospheric pressure, or air pressure as we call it. And this is all from National Geographic. The air around you has weight and it presses against everything that it touches. That pressure is called atmospheric pressure or air pressure. It's a force exerted on the surface by the air above it as gravity pulls it to Earth. Atmospheric pressure is commonly measured by a barometer. Barometer is a column of mercury in a glass tube that rises or falls as the weight of the atmosphere changes. Meteorologists describe the atmospheric pressure by how high the mercury rises. So scientists use a tool, this tool is called a barometer, and they look at the level of mercury and they're able to determine the air pressure. Now, why does this matter? Air pressure is actually really cool, and it's important when we're going to be talking about the weather. So here are four different demonstrations done by your teachers, and you'll get to see a little bit about how air pressure works.
So as Chloe lays down sleeping on this couch, just like she's putting pressure on the couch cushions because she's laying on it, there's actually air that's putting pressure on top of her and on the sides of her. That's a good girl, Chloe. Chloe, say hi. Say hi. She's tired.
Oh, hi there, sixth graders. I'm just doing a science experiment in my garage. I have some liquid in here, and what I'm gonna do is make sure it's kind of coated around the bottle, and then I use a little rubber eraser for my kids. They let me borrow it, and I'm gonna add some air in here. I'm gonna add some air pressure in here. Tell me what you think's gonna happen when I release it. Ooh. I think I just made a cloud. What do you think about that? You know what happens with clouds? What you get with clouds? With clouds, you get rain. Raining down some three-pointers.
Hey guys, so today I'm gonna be doing a science experiment. I have this hard-boiled egg, I have a glass milk jar, I have some matches, and I have a piece of paper. I wanna see if there is any way I can get the egg, which obviously it doesn't fit, to get inside the glass milk jar using only flame. What do you think? You think it's gonna work? All right, let's try it. Okay, so why do you think this happened? How was I able to get the egg inside the milk jar?
Okay. So why do I have a can of Dr. Pepper sitting on top of the stove? It's probably got something to do with pressure. So I have a little bit of water in there, and then I have a bowl here with ice cold water. So we're gonna let it heat up for a couple minutes. So you can see there's some steam coming out of the top, and you can hear the water boiling. So you want to wait until it's been boiling for a couple minutes.
5 minutes later.
All right, here we go. So I'm using safety equipment, tongs. Then you're going to invert it. You're going to turn it upside down and put it into cold water. And just like that, it collapses based on air pressure. Crushed it.
All right, students, I'm going to show you a demonstration about how air pressure and air in our atmosphere works out. To do this, we're going to use a couple of tools. I have some hot water boiling on the stove. I have some ice water here in this white bowl. And then I have a glass bottle with a balloon attached to the top, creating a seal. So all the air that's in here is all the air that should stay there. So there shouldn't be any air going in or out. Now, since we are doing a demonstration with glass, heat, things like that, it can get a little dicey. So I have a lab coat to help keep me safe. You don't need one, I just have it to look cool. Some type of eye protection. Nothing bad should go wrong, but we do want to be safe. And of course, I am working with hot and cold materials, so having some type of insulation, like an oven mitt, so I can grab hot and cold things will be great. Let's get started.